In this lab, we'll be working on conservation of energy with Hot Wheels. Specifically, we'll look at how much kinetic and potential energy the car has at the top of the hill, at the bottom of the hill, and where it ends up on top on the other side. The track here consists of the launcher, so that we can release it consistently. And we'll have tracks and connectors. And a little bit of tape to keep it all together. So you'll notice that it's a little finicky, so you might have to try and align it and adjust it a few times before you have the car running smoothly. And we'll do it one more time in slow motion so that you can better see what's going on. So in this system, we're specifically interested in three different points: at the top of the hill, at the bottom of the hill, and at the top on the other side. To get the potential energy at the top here, we need the vertical distance from the top to the bottom on each of the sides. And to get the kinetic energy in the middle, we'll need actually the speed of the car. To get the speed, we'll be using the photogates. The photogates here sends a signal to the computer, as you can see here, whenever the car is interrupting the light beam. And from that, we can work out how long the light beam has been interrupted for, and from that, we can work out its speed. Given the time from the photogates, we will also have to measure the length of the car that's interrupting the photogates. Now, we have to pay attention because the car is irregularly shaped, so we have to kind of figure out at what level the car hits the beam, and we'll be measuring the distance at that point. So it's roughly there, in this case. Lastly, to figure out the average friction as it comes down this part of the ramp, we would have to measure the length of the path between the top of the mountain and to where it goes through the photogates. And it's up to you to figure out the best way how. You can consult your handout for more details.